Hi, my name is Dennis Marcellino. The video you're about to see contains the highlights of my 40 years in music and writing. So sit back and enjoy an opening, and I'll be back in a while.
Francisco's a pretty special place in a lot of ways. The hills, the Golden Gate Bridge, the cable cars, and the music. They're all San Francisco landmarks. Some really great groups have come out of that city. And now there's another one to add to the list. They are truly incredible people, incredible musicians. They are Rubicon.
There's more to come when Cal Jam 2 continues in a moment.
Well, all right.
Several weeks ago, a quarter of a million people listened to them at the California Jam. You're about to hear why. Please welcome Rubicon.
Oh, San Francisco Bay Area has provided several of rock music's most popular groups over the years. Santana, Jefferson Airplane, Grateful Dead, Sly and the Family Stone, to name a few. Today, we're going to bring to you a new group from the San Francisco Bay Area. It was started from a former member of Sly Stone's band, and they have a new album on 20th Century Fox Records and a new single on the charts, which they'll do a little later. Right now, with Cheatin', here is Rubicon.
Interesting background. We're going to find out more about them in a second. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Rubicon. Saxophone player right here.
Dennis Marcellino played with Electric Flag and Elvin Bishop. And with me, for the last 2 years, I was with Sly. And he just came right along with
us. Just straggled along. Couldn't get over here on bass.
On bass. That's Jack Blades. I met him at a Sly concert about 4 years ago, and he was going to San Diego State as a biochemist.
Dennis, how many hours a day does a band practice before they get out and really work professionally?
Oh, for about the last 2 years, about 4 or 5 hours a day.
A day?
Yeah.
Does it get boring?
5 days a week. No, it gets serious.
Weekends off.
Your weekends off, though, really? No.
Before moving on, let's get in our time machine and back up a little. No, not that far. Keep going. Whoops.
You're adorable.
Keep going.
You're a cutie.
Keep going. Keep going. By the way, I'm the Cub Scout next to the teacher. Okay. After playing 2 years in the Rose Parade and the 1962 Seattle World's Fair, I had a band in high school called the Spotlighters. This is my high school dance band. Notice the then popular Beatle coat I was wearing. My first full-time professional band was the Season of Soul. My first big break was becoming a member of the Electric Flag. I then joined a band with now famous CCM artist Leon Patillo. Notice the photographer's shadow on the band on the album cover. Leon went on to play with Santana while I toured and recorded with Elvin Bishop. I began my plunge into the Spinal Tap years by joining Sly and the Family Stone. While on tour with Sly in Hawaii, I and Sly co-founder Jerry Martini met up with some investors who urged us to start our own band. So with their backing, we did. It started out as Source and then became Rubicon, which you saw at the beginning of this tape. This is a single release we did in Japan. Speaking of Spinal Tap, here we are backstage with an agent, and on the far left, our producer, Richie Podler, who also produced all the hits of Three Dog Night, Steppenwolf, and Iron Butterfly. Here I am with Jack Blades, who changed the name of Rubicon to Night Ranger and went on to earn platinum albums. After Rubicon, I moved to LA to team up with my cousin Jerry Marcellino, who produced and wrote for Michael Jackson, Bobby Darin, and Diana Ross. The name of the band was Dennis and the Menaces. By the way, that name wasn't my idea. I have other relatives who've also been successful in the music business, like Vince Guaraldi, who did all the soundtracks for Peanuts and Charlie Brown, and had the big hit record, Cast Your Fate to the Wind. Also, Muzzy Marcellino, besides being the band director for the Art Linkletter show, was a famous whistler who whistled on the two hit soundtracks for the movies, The High and the Mighty and The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. My cousin Gene was bass player for Gary Lewis and the Playboys.
And there's my cousin Jaco Marcellino,
who's the leader of Sha Na Na, who I played with for a short time. And then there was my cousin Sonny Bono, whose footsteps I hope to follow in someday in being able to have an effect in the political world. So in the 1970s, I had two relatives who had top 10 TV shows.
Good. You're very talented, CC. Have you been in this business before? In your country?
No, ma'am. This is the first time I've orchestrated. Next time, I will do much better.
It's good. It's really good. All right, let me tell you what we've done. We have presented your music to Mr. Lazzari, and he wants to use it for his new movie soundtrack.
I think a classic like Beethoven's Eighth Symphony would work great in a scene where her boyfriend...
Oh, no, Joe, baby. No classic stuff.
No classic stuff. I want something that's going to sell. Now, you get a score in there that's rock and roll. Something that'll get them dancing in the aisles. Know what I mean? Something that'll move them. Mr. Lazzari, we can't make just a totally commercial picture. Now, please, try to think of it artistically. Artistically? Joe, don't talk to me about artistically. You know what artistically means? Artistically means Fellini, an 8.5. You know what he got for 8.5? Zero. Goose egg. Bankruptcy. I am tired of commercialism. I want to show people that Hollywood is not completely stupid.
Thank you. Dawson, Pete Rose. Show it to us one more time.
Fabian, join us for Let's Rock Tonight concert, an all-star, all-for-one status symbol. In fact, the Thunderbird was so popular that when John Kennedy ordered 25 for his inaugural parade, four didn't have any left. They were all sold out. That same year, our next group recorded a hit which soared to number one on the charts and has sold over 12 million copies. Ladies and gentlemen, The Tokens.
You know, this really does look like a diner from the 50s.
To commit to one person yet.
I guess I knew that. I'm sorry, Wally.
Me too.
Bye-bye, love. Bye-bye, happiness. Hello, loneliness. I think I'm gonna cry. Goodbye, my love, goodbye.
Someday, if you're lucky, you'll grow up to be just like us.
I promised myself that I'd try to make contact with my fellow humans. But I'm willing to accept a thing. After after one more try.
Oh, please. Get a rest.
Can you move over, please?
Acapella, no instruments. That's
okay.
Like this.
Bum, 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 bum.
Hush, my darling, don't fear, my darling. The lion sleeps tonight.
Man, that's so beautiful.
They love you.
They do, you know.
The lion sleeps. The lion sleeps. Tonight.
Oh, 1, 2, ha!
Thank you.
I said, bring it on home. I said, bring it on home. I said, bring it on home.
A very current album out called Re-Doo-Wop. The notion of this is the re-recording
of
all those great classics, and it's a very modern and unique album. Listen to this opening medley. Little Star Hushabye by Little Darlin'. Sorry I Ran All the Way Home. Do You Want to Dance? Twist and Shout. Do You Love Me? And La Bamba. And that's just the first cut on the album.
Michael Johnson. This is
the Tokens have returned to the studio and performance venues to promote a new album, their first in decades, called Re-Doo-Wop. But the return of the Tokens is no nostalgia-fueled grab for a final moment in showbiz. In fact, the members of the Tokens have never left the industry. Mitch Margo composes TV soundtracks. Norman Bergen is an arranger and producer. Newest member Dennis Marcellino is a veteran of Sly and the Family Stone and a published author. Phil Margo has moved beyond the music industry into film and TV as a writer and producer. So the lion sleeps again for a while, and the Tokens have returned to their distinctive music direct from the dawn of the space age.
Actually, this December 7th will be the
chain. Here to count them down, the group that sang about a sleeping lion in 1961 and now has a new album out.
Hi, we're the Tokens. I'm Phil,
Dennis,
Mitch,
and Norman.
And we're here to bring you this week's Billboard Top 10. And that's the Top 10. We're the Tokens. See you.
See you.
On the
top. That was cool.
National recording artist Dennis Marcellino, who has established himself as one of the greatest sax players in the world. He's played with the Coasters.
Take out the papers and the trash.
He was musical director for the Shirelles.
Where will you love me tomorrow?
He was with the Drifters.
Under the boardwalk.
Listen to some of the other groups with whom Dennis played, as if this musical resume isn't good enough. Sly and the Family Stone, the number one band of the world in 1969.
Welcome to the Fox 10 o'clock.
Marcellino.
Thank you, thank you.
Like Lucia said, my name is Dennis Marcellino, or as my family used to say, Dentista Giuseppe Marcellino. Actually, there's really no such name as Dentista, but they never heard the name Dennis before. So they thought they were saying dentist. They said Dentista, they call me Dentista. I'm basically a pop singer, but I'm gonna try an opera song today for the first time. So I'm gonna call it Popera, Pop and Opera. We'll see how it goes.
La donna mobile, qua più mal vento, muta d'accento e di pensiero. Sempre una mobile, leggiadro viso, in pianto liso e menzognero.
Thank you. It does not take, you don't have to be a rocket scientist to be a senator.
Oh, it helps.
Do you still have my resume that
yes.
I asked you? Okay, on my resume, the first thing on there was, actually, I was a rocket scientist.
Uh-oh. Trouble.
I was an aerospace engineer, and I don't know if that helps or hurts. The one thing that I did learn from my science training that I try to explain in my letter to you was that in science you come to the point where, you know, there's an optimum decision. There's only actually one that's going to work. And that's my desire, is to get to that optimum decision. You know, that kind of delineates between, you know, Republican or Democrat or, you know, whatever. There's an optimum decision to be made on each issue. And that's what I'd like to shoot for, you know, gather the data and work with people and be open to what anybody had to say and shoot for that decision. You know, when I talked to a few friends of mine about the fact that I was running for this, the immediate response was, you know, in each different position, one was in the public school system, one was in the highway division, and they all said, at the end of the fiscal year, we have this ton of money that we're given this mandate, spend it or lose it. You know, and they all and they told me each how much money they had and how they had a cram to spend. One guy had to spend $37,000 on a computer system, and that he didn't need. And that all three of them came up with the same thing. But as far as, you know, as far as crime goes and funding it, I think that one thing that I bring that fuels my passion for wanting to be in politics is that I've watched two cities go down very badly. San Francisco and Los Angeles. I grew up in San Francisco and I lived in Los Angeles for 10 years. They both were really nice when they started out, just like Clackamas County is. And I saw what caused it. And so I think there's some stopgap measures that you can take to prevent crime. And those are the kind of things I'd like to bring.
Would you please describe your philosophy of government?
I see myself as being conservative and a Christian, and you know, I saw in the paper where in the paper article in Metro where Vern Duncan said that we were extreme right wing, and so I had this thought that I wrote down about that, and what I wrote was, I wrote, you know, I don't get it, because I stand for love and strict obedience to the law, this earns me the brand of extreme. Surely I must be wrongly interpreting their use of the word extreme. They surely must mean the Bible works extremely well, and following it makes me an extremely good citizen, an extremely good family member, an extremely positive and healthy person, an extremely loyal friend, and an extremely effective contributor to life. And all of this after having approached life the world's way, the world in quotes, and trusting and finding myself extremely mired in troubles and extremely unhappy. So, you know, to me, you know, I've lived life, you know, like the world's way, you know, quote unquote, and I didn't find success there. I started following the Bible, and I found success. It's a technical manual from a scientific standpoint to me on how to approach life.
Now, fans, please welcome representatives from the Vancouver Fire Department who are presenting our nation's colors tonight. And now, fans, at this time, please rise and remove your hats. Join former member of the Elvin Bishop Group, the Tokens, and Sly and the Family Stone, Dennis Marcellino, with the playing of both the Canadian and American national anthem. and gentlemen, Dennis Marcellino. Check out DennisSax.com.
I used to be a member of some top name bands in the 60s, 70s, and 80s, most notably Sly and the Family Stone, the Alvin Bishop Group, the Electric Five, and Rubicon. And I used to also tour as a musician and vocalist with Three Dog Night, the Coasters, and Sha Na Na, and a bunch of other groups. But there's one group that had a hit that sold 12.5 million copies. And if I told you the name of the band, you probably wouldn't know. But you will recognize it here. The name of the band was The Tokens. Oh. Okay.
I think we're finally at the point where the performers were alive during the era that they're going to be playing. Actually, I used to be a member of a band that had a hit record that sold over 12.5 million copies. And if I told you the name of the band, you probably wouldn't know what the hit was, but the name of the band was The Tokens. Oh, that's right, it's in the program. Okay, sorry. Okay, so here's the song. We
Dennis Marcellino, can you just thank him again? It was tremendous.